Starting anew. This short sentence, this combination of words, conjure up thoughts of freshness, cleanness, hopefulness, endless possibilities. Its hidden meaning brings thoughts of ruin, messiness, regret, mistakes. Who would ever want to begin anew something that is going well? A new year brings thoughts of a fresh start. But because we did not choose to have a new beginning, we may feel unprepared for it. In order for a new year to be new, we must decide to let go of the old year, the burden of pain, disappointments, failures, unfulfilled longings must be given up. This is easier said than done. These burdens have scarred us. We are haunted by memories, by images, by words, thoughts, and desires. We have longings that do not go away until they are fulfilled. It does not matter what the date is. In the Word of God, we are told that the best of everything is ahead of us. Yes, the Bible has lots to say about the hard, horrible times before us. But even then, it says, the best is yet to come. Letting go of the year just ended with its burden of grief, pain, sadness, disappointments would be much easier if we take the view of the Bible, best days are ahead of us. God's promise is to make all things new. He promises, behold, I make all things new. That's found in Revelation 21:5. God promises to give us new hearts, found in Ezekiel 36:26. He promises to make a new covenant with us, in Jeremiah 31:31. He speaks of a new song that we will sing, in Revelation 5:9. A new name given to us, in Revelation 2:17. He speaks of a new and living way in Hebrews 10:20, a new creature in Galatians 6:15. He even speaks of a new man in Ephesians 4:24, a new heaven and a new earth in Revelation 21:1. New beginnings are ahead. It is a promise of God. No matter what we struggle with presently, new beginnings are ahead for each of us in Christ. With this in mind, let us let go of the past. Let us let go of the regrets, the disappointments, the hurts, the pains, and look forward with hope in God for the fulfillment of the new beginning He has promised each of us. Thank you for listening. Please be sure to join me soon for another reading.